Hello and welcome to Storytium. Today I'm going to show you how to make some basic, clean, cinematic looking titles in Adobe Premiere Pro. When it comes to titles, Premiere is kinda limited and clunky compared to what you can do with After Effects, for example. But if you know how to use it and put it on the right footage, it can still look great. And in this tutorial, I'm going to help you with that by making this simple title animation and also this more advanced one. And I will also show you how to save this as a template to be used in future projects. Before we head over to Premiere, I want to give a huge shout out to the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is a great source for all your creative projects. They offer millions of high quality items like stock videos and images, music and sound effects, but also many transition templates and presets. If you want to try them out, then use the link in the video description to claim a discount on your first month. The links can be found in the video description. Okay, now it's time to start some editing in Premiere. We're going to start by adding some text. You can do this with the type tool, which you can enable here. And then you can click anywhere in the program monitor and start typing. To exit type mode, hit Ctrl plus Enter and then hit the V key to go back to the selection tool. And then you could use the Essential Graphics panel to do some text adjustments. As you can see, for this example, I'm using the Montserrat font. And for font weight, I've selected bold. Next, I'm going to center the text by clicking here and also align it to the center by clicking on these two buttons here. Then I'm going to move it up a little bit because we need some space for the subtitle. So this is the space that we're going to use for the subtitle. And to add this subtitle, we're going to use this same type tool again. And then I'll just click in the program monitor and start typing, and in this case I'll type modern and simple. Then exit type mode and go over to the Essential Graphics panel to change some settings. First I'll change the font weight. And let's change the font size to 50. Then also center the text and align it vertically. And I'm also going to move this one up just a little bit. I think this is already starting to look pretty good. Let's improve it further by adding some space between the characters, and we can do this by playing around with the tracking value. Okay, in the next step we're going to increase the duration of the title. I'm going to extend this to 10 seconds, but of course you can use any length that you prefer. In the next step we're going to add an effect. In the effects panel we're going to search for the Gaussian blur effect. You'll find this one under video effects, blur and sharpen. I'm going to apply this one to the text layer and then head over to the effects control panel, and in there I'm going to enable keyframes for blurriness by clicking on the stopwatch icon. That created the first keyframe that we can put somewhere over here. Then create a second keyframe and move that one somewhere here. And then I'm going to create two keyframes with value 150. I'm going to put these keyframes at the beginning and the end of the timeline. And with these four keyframes, we've now created this blur in and out effect. Next, we're going to do the same for opacity. As you can see, it already has keyframes enabled, so let's create the first one and put it over here. In this case, I want to align the keyframes with the ones from the Gaussian blur effect. Next to the two keyframes with 100%, we also want two keyframes with 0%, and we want these two at the beginning and the end of the timeline. Now, besides blur in and out, it will also fade in and out. We're almost there for this basic animation, but we need two more keyframes, and those are for scaling. I'm going to put the keyframe with value 100 at the end and then create another keyframe by changing the value to 85. And then put that keyframe at the beginning of the timeline. Now the title will zoom in very subtle and it will look like this. And if you add this on top of some stock footage from Envato Elements, it will look like this. As I promised, I'm going to make it a bit more advanced. The starting point here is where I've got two lines of text, just like I made earlier in this tutorial. And you can also see the two lines here in the Essential Graphics panel. And besides that, I've also got two keyframes for scaling enabled, which gives a subtle zoom. We're going to start by adding a small line between the two titles, and we're going to do this with the rectangle tool, which you can find here. You can draw a shape in the program monitor by holding the left mouse button. And after that, we could go to the Essential Graphics panel, center it, and also reposition it slightly. Next, we're going to enable the selection tool again by hitting the V key or click this icon here and then head over to the effects control panel. If we open up the shape layer, which represents the line, you can see that the anchor point is at 0x0, which is here at the left top corner of the shape. We want this to be in the center, so I'm going to move this blue crosshair. And with the anchor point on the right position, we can start animating. And to do this, we'll go into scaling properties and then first disable uniform scale. Then I'm going to enable keyframes for horizontal scale and move the keyframe with value 100 somewhere over here. Then create another keyframe with value 0 and put that one at the beginning. And with these two keyframes, we've now created this short line animation. And to make it all a bit more smoother, we're going to right click on the last keyframe and then select Ease In. In the next steps, we're going to animate the text. So I'm going to close the shape layer for now and then go to the modern and simple text layer. And in here, we're going to click on this pen icon to create a mask. First, I'm going to search for the point where the text is the largest and then use the pen tool to create a mask around the text. After that, we can go back to the effects control panel and in the text layer enable keyframes for position. Take this first keyframe and move it somewhere over here for now. Then move a couple of frames back and change the position. It should be right outside of the mask. That will create a second keyframe, and with these two keyframes, we've now created this animation. Next, we can do the same with the title on top. So let's close this text layer and then open the one from the cinematic title. Also here, we're going to use the pen tool to draw a rectangle mask around the title. And then we need to go back to the effects control panel and enable keyframes for position. Take that first keyframe and move it somewhere over here. Then go a couple of frames back at the point where the animation starts. And then change the position of the text and move it right outside of the mask at the height of the line. And that's how you create this modern and clean animated title. In the final part of this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can save this as a template for future projects. This is really simple. You need to right-click on the text layer on the timeline and then select Export as Motion Graphic Template. In the window that pops up, you can give a name to your template. And if you click Local Drive, you can export this to your PC or Mac. Click on Browse to go to the folder that you would like to use for the export and then click on Select Folder. And if I now click on OK, Premiere will export a .mogurt file. And then if you want to reuse this template, you need to go to the Essential Graphics panel and then import the file by clicking on this plus icon here. Then browse to the file that you would like to import and click Open. And then finally, if you go back to the Essential Graphics panel, you will find your preset here in the Browse tab. You can then simply drag this over to the timeline and start adjusting the text. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you would like to see more of my tutorials, then check out one of these two. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.